Dear learners, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Saurabh Dikshit from Indian Institute of Tourism and Travel Management, Gwalior. Today, we shall be taking module number 1 titled Understanding Importance of Guiding under the paper Tour Guiding Essentials. Dear learners, after studying this module, you shall be in position to explain the following objectives. These objectives are, you can listen to me once again, importance of tourism, to know the historical background of tour guiding and basic of tour guiding. What are the basic concepts of tour guiding? Now let us discuss introductory part. India is a country where the language, food and attire changes every 10 kilometers. People here have diverse languages, dialects, accents and attires, yet our hearts remain Indian. We are imbibed by one common feeling, that is, we are Indian. When there is cricket match, Indians throughout hold their breaths and hope their team wins. When there is a casualty on border, we remain with the nation. India has many languages and dialects and a multiplicity of culture and is united in the face of all this. When a tourist starts from his place, he has a dream to see unique places and wants to have unique experience. Travel services are purchased in advance by the customer or consumer. A customer or consumer looks for the best service for the price which he pays to different stakeholders. These stakeholders are airlines operators, event organizers, hoteliers, tea stall owners, or to only one stakeholder, a travel agent. Travel agent is the key entity liaising with many services producers. A tour starts with a lot of planning, usually by tour operators. Tour operators are experienced in this job. They design an itinerary in such a way that the tourists get the maximum satisfaction or utmost satisfaction during their travel. A tour largely consists of two parts. First part is inorganic part and second part is organic part. Tourists use various means of transportation, hotel rooms, use machines like escalators, self-operated kiosk, etc. These are the inorganic parts of touring. On the other hand, tourists interact with tour escorts, guides, leaders, and tour managers. These people try their best to satisfy the tourist. Through good tour services, a tour guide works on present to experts from history for tourists or make the place alive by telling interesting stories. This is the organic part of tour package. There are three kinds of professionals work with the group in the field. First is tour guide, second is tour escort, and third is tour manager. We can also take tour leader. Tour guide is basically associated with whole day tour guiding assignment to the monument, palace, natural place, hills, adventure activities, ruined structures, devastated cities, spiritual or religious place like Jagannath Puri, etc. He handles tour group at the tourism attraction. His work is practical and field work. He speaks the language preferred by the tour group. Tour guide is authority by the travel agent and certified by appropriate authority. Now let us talk about jobs of a tour guide. What is the basic job of a tour guide? You must have heard at times that a tour guide should be responsible and should complete his or her assignment on time. Responsibilities refers to successfully expediting your work with full devotion. A tour guide has many responsibilities, for example, reaching hotel on time, asking all the team members or group members about their likings and dislikings to ensure that facilities and amenities on the way to take the tourist to marked places in the itinerary on time, etc. It is the responsibility of a tour guide to help travelers understand the place or monument or theme park or location, etc. Understanding a place means knowing its importance culturally and historically, and to be aware of the culture of the region and the way of life of its inhabitants. They have to promote the cultural heritage and rely to the visitors the significance of the place they are visiting. Next topic is importance of tour guides in tourism and travel business. Tour guiding is an old profession. The concept of tour guides has existed since ancient time. All over the world, tour guides help you locate the place, to know each and every details of the place, to interpret icons, to understand the culture of the place. Culture of the place means they will tell you about dances, music, dresses, attire, etc. To understand language and interact with the locals. Suppose tourist is from England, tour guide will understand language of tourist, that is English, as well as he will interact with locals and he can speak the local language also, that is Marathi or Hindi. And to enjoy, tourist guide play a major role by escorting tourist and interpreting places for unique feel. A tour manager or guide is the most important person for a tour operator. He is the link between tourist and tour operator. He has to liaison different things, different jobs between tourist and tour operator. The success or failure of a tour depends on the capability to handle a particular tour. He has more significance in adventure tour because the specialized nature of this kind of activity. Thus, most companies expect that the guide must have better experience in leading tours. The roles and expectations of a tour operator are listed below. The tour manager or tour guide acts as a representative of the travel company. Tour manager or guide also acts as arbitrator in case of any problem or dispute between group members and locals or company. Tour guide has to work as arbitrator in case of any confusion or confrontation, like the quality of service. The tour manager has to take appropriate decision on the spot. The tour operator has comprehensive responsibility to put the tour together, expedite reservations, do marketing or handle money related aspects of any tour, and manage tour managers or guide. Without a tour guide, a tour is not interesting. There is no story and amusement. If there is no guide, there is no story in the tour package. That is why tour guide is very important. Tour guide engages the tourist with chit chat and keeps them busy all the time. While they are seeing the monument, they are going here and there. He or she also suggests what to and what not to eat. He or she also suggests the local cuisines to you. Like if you are going to Delhi, you can go to Parathe Wala Gali and you can enjoy local cuisine there. People going to Tel Aviv may enjoy the local cuisine or famous restaurants of Tel Aviv. They can also know about culture of Tel Aviv. For example, in Israel, people settle differences on the dinner table in a good restaurant. Thus, tour guide can connect the tourist with the place. Otherwise, the tourist will simply go to the place and come back after seeing it without connecting with the place. Now let us talk about tourism through ages. Tourism is an activity in which someone travels to a place which is unusual for him. He stays for more than 24 hours and less than 1 or 2 years. He travels for more than 24 hours and stays in a commercial accommodation. In India, there was a concept of Deshatan, Tirthatan and Paryatan. It was activity based on emphasis. Based on activity based emphasis was given to experience gained by the tourist. During ancient time, when India had trade relations with Afghanistan, Iran, Indonesia, Bali, Java, Sumatra, China, many Indian businessmen traveled to these countries via waterways. They spread our culture. Also, during the time of Britishers, many Indians were taken to Fiji, Mauritius and other islands and got settled there. So, Indian rituals, festivals are followed not only in India, many other countries also. Many travelers accounted their travelogues, their writings beautifully. They have narrated India as a treasure of attractions. These travelers were Huizen, Fayyan, Ibn Battuta, Vasco da Gama, etc. Arabs started calling India as amazing place, and now it is incredible India in English. Chardham. There are 4 pilgrimage centers in India. These centers are Badrinath in north, Jagannath Puri in Odisha in the east, Dwarka in Gujarat in the west, and Rameshwaram in south. These are major pilgrimage centers in the country. People visit these places since time immemorial and feel blissful. There are 12 or Dwadash Jyotirling of Lord Shiva. Now let us talk about spa. Spa is a famous place for hot sulfur water spring. During old time, doctors were prescribing bath in hot sulfur water spring to get rid of skin diseases. It was a common practice. People going for such purpose given the name of spa tourist. Now let us talk about grand tours. There was a fixed itinerary tour for affluent class youth to see France, Italy and other countries. It was given the name of grand tours. Tourism is a multifaceted activity. People travel for some purpose. There are a number of forms of tourism like medical tourism, adventure tourism, health tourism, ecotourism, rural tourism, sustainable tourism, hill or mountain tourism, dark tourism, it is also known as Thana tourism, special tourism or special interest tourism, etc. Tourism is a old, very old concept. People started traveling since time immemorial. Just after learning plucking of fruits from trees and agriculture, it was the travel via waterways, probably first mode of travel in sea and rivers. Later on, when pathways were created through forest, people traveled for warfares and pilgrimage. Travel got boost up after the introduction of currency, wheel, passport like documents, and further momentum after change of holidays into holidays. In the middle of 20th century, Thomas Cook gave concept of tour en masse. It was like manufacturing a tour, tourism services for mass production. It is like mass production. Many people, they are traveling together to a particular place. They are traveling by train, they are traveling by tourist coaches. So here tourism activity is meant for many number of people. Mr. Pullman coaches were the beginning point of tourist coaches. Mr. Avis introduced car rental concept. There were hiccups during World War I and World War II, but in post-World War period, travel got momentum due to jet technology and internet. The greatest game changer in speed of aircraft by jet technology and speed of signals by the internet. These two inventions happened during the time of World War. People started traveling in peaceful era after World War as governments of many emerging economies opened their doors for tourists in expectation to earn foreign exchange, and people in developed economies were seeking for relaxed atmosphere in new destinations. After the successful climbing of Mount Everest, the greatest peak in Himalayas, Government of India established mountaineering institutes at Manali, that is in Himachal Pradesh, Joshimath, that is in Uttarakhand, Pehelgaon, that is in Kashmir, Jammu and Kashmir, and Darjeeling to motivate youth of India towards adventure activities. It was a major step towards development of adventure tourism in India. In the field of water sports, National Institute of Water Sports, NIWS, was created in Goa, Panjim. Bharat Mahotsav tourist offices of Ministry of Tourism and strong force of NRIs are constantly making efforts to market India outside the country. Last decade of 20th century saw great change in cruise tourism. Beginning of 21st century confessed online travel companies working in big way. When tourism got the shape planned, designed, integration of various resources like tourist transport, accommodation, food, recreation, etc., tour guide services became imperative or important to assist the group and take care of tour package software. In India, foundation of tourism was kept after constitution of one committee under Sir Sargent to take initiatives for the development of tourism. Initially, ITDC was created. ITDC is India Tourism Development Corporation. Hotels were built for travelers. In later stage, government opened many educational establishments to develop human resources in country. There are about more than 70 universities, colleges, private and government institutions are offering tourism, travel and hospitality related courses. IITTM, NCHMCT and IHM's FCI Culinary Institute are major institutes in this area. Beside tourism department in Bundelkhand University, Punjab University, Chandigarh, Himachal Pradesh University in Shimla, Kurukshetra University in Kurukshetra, HNB Gadhwal University in Srinagar, Uttarakhand, etc. Many state governments created tourism development corporations and tourism department in these states to ensure more and faster development. Many new trains introduced in last 50 years like Shatabdi Express, Palace on Wheels, Duronto Express, Rajdhani Express, Gatiman Express for metro cities, metro trains were planned, and new concept are also tried, that is monorail. In hilly regions, toy trains got facelift and popularity due to access to panoramic views of mountains. Now let us talk about deregulation of airline sector, adjusted pricing strategy, and more number of people started traveling by air. Low cost carriers got popularity and services to new places. Helicopter service is also more common and accessible by many middle class pilgrims who want to travel in less time. IRCTC introduced many innovations in train journey and catering services. Now people are more accustomed to internet ticket, one step ahead of computerized ticket, and hygiene and food services at their restaurants, that is cumsum. But restructuring of international economies, recession made sudden emergencies like SARS, tsunami, earthquake, etc. it is more sensitive in taught tourism industry players to plan and then operate. Still, there are few challenges of tourism industry. These challenges are rush and crush traffic. Rush and crush traffic means one place is very popular, more number of tourists rush to that place, and after many years that place is spoiled because of pollution and many other problems. Sustainability, seasonality, pricing of products, segmentation, etc. In future, tourism is expected to become major industry of the world. There will be more growth in its allied sector, that is cargo and logistics, events, hospitality, airlines, etc. There will be stiff competition among Asian countries to get the better share of tourist traffic bound to Asia from other continents and countries. Traffic will increase towards Africa as it will grow more industrially in coming days. New places will emerge and existing will saturate. People will travel quite often with their family and friends. Family tours will be marketed more in coming days, as obviously people would like to spend more and more time with their family members due to hectic lifestyle. New modes of clean transport will be introduced in coming days. These clean transports are battery run cars or hybrid vehicles will be common in coming days. There will be more number of capsule hotels. There will be more choice in food segment. Tour guide will be full of information. His role will be more facilitating. Budget tourist will also prefer to hire a tour guide services, keeping in mind his valuable information and support to the tourist. Now tourists are also categorized as mass tourists, backpackers, excursionists, foreign individual tourists, that is FIT, etc. Next subtopic is why guiding is important. An important question for every tour guide is why guiding is necessary for a traveler. Will it survive after introduction of high-tech devices like audio guide, consoles, apps for guiding virtually? What are the strengths of a tour guide? A tour guide must know the following these points, like origin of various religions. Various religions have their roots in India, and because of this, people all over the world, they look towards India. Like from many countries, Japan, China, Thailand, Cambodia, Vietnam, Buddhist tourists, they come to see Buddhist pilgrimage places in India. Many have dream of visiting shrines, monuments and other religious places of Lord Buddha, Lord Rama and Sufi saints like Muhammad Ghaus Sahib. Place of learning. India holds great value for those who wants to travel, learn yoga, meditation, Ayurveda, Sanskrit, traditional dances and much more. Places of heritage. India has many heritage sites. These sites offer a view to rich past of our country, that is India. Through the eyes of a tour guide, places with rich culture. India is a country with warm climate and good agriculture resources. Apart from this, rivers like Ganges, Yamuna, Kaveri and Mahanadi ensure good crop, thus allowing people to enjoy culture. Diverse places, culture, traditions at one place. When people visit India, they could see many things. One can find mountains, vast plains, deserts, ravines, snow and beaches all in one country. That is the beauty of India. Sensitization, tour guide sensitize people about rich past, many issues related to environment and changing time. They make our past presentable. When you will go to Ajanta Ellora, tour guides are very sensitive towards use of polybags. cleanliness in caves and tourist area, they educate visitors about the environment. They connect stories with present-day problems. Multiple views and thoughts are there are diverse views and thoughts in our country. It is welcomed in the democratic system of India. India has had a well-developed system to deal with travel since ancient time. We had the concept of Deshatan, Tirthatan, Paryatan, people traveling to religious places for salvation were kept under the category of Tirthatan. In our system, in Indian system, travel was always linked with its purpose. People going to religious places were helped by pandas in offering prayer and completing rituals. It was a relationally rich network. People were going to places for business, had identified locals that could help them to liaison with the local businessmen. These merchants also had arrangements for their stay in that place. During the time of Sher Shah Suri, sarais were constructed on roadsides for the purpose of accommodation. Linkage, a tour guide links you with the locals and helps to get knowledge about villagers' living style, food habits, their languages. Sometimes he acts as a translator. He creates sense of trust for villagers as well as visitor. Now let us talk about history of tour guiding. Tour guiding is considered as one of the oldest occupations, professions of the West. The evolution of tour guides and the guiding history was classified by Pond in 1993 into four periods. First phase was from 3000 before Christ to 500 after AD. There are a number of references in history from the Roman Empire to the Middle Age throughout the Renaissance and into the modern age. Tourism saw the first major development during the period of the great empires. During this period, traveling was risky, uncertain, and time-taking. The ancient Persians, Assyrians, and Egyptians used to travel through surface, means land, and the waterways. This activity spread, and so did the number of guides. They were known as, during that time, they were known as explainers and leaders around, as they lead the group who mainly assisted visitors traveling abroad. Second phase of tour guiding was AD 500 to AD 1500. The second phase is in this period between the fall of Rome Empire, the start of Renaissance, known as the Middle Age, and the approximately it is 100 years from AD 500 to 1500. Religious pilgrimage was the most prevalent type of journey by the middle and the upper classes. The fall of Rome resulted in the decline of the economy and chaos in the social order. The safety and security of the travelers came as serious concern. Therefore, the guides had to serve as a pathfinder, safety escort, and protector also. Now let us talk about third phase, that is from AD 1500 to around 1700. The third phase covered the period of the Renaissance and the Grand Tour, approximately AD 1500 to around 1700. During the period of Renaissance, excursions were taken by the youth of prosperous families who were also called grand tourists for cultural and educational reasons. These people, tourists, were expected to enrich their knowledge through long journeys while being accompanied by a guide who gave them information about tourist places to sightsee. Guides in this period came to be known as Cicerone. The word Cicerone derived from Cicero, the most esteemed tour guide in the European society. The guide was expected to be well versed in many practical subjects, areas, to be articulate and be multilingual. Fourth stage, post-1700, Mr. Jan Carlsson, the former president of Scandinavian Airline, termed the exact instant when the customer, here tourist, has direct contact with any of the frontline employee or staff as the moment of truth. This idea had a marked influence on the service industry. Tourism and travel is a part of service industry and is now globally accepted. It is said by Pond in 1993. Once the tourist arrives at the tourist destination, the tour guide becomes responsible throughout the tour as they are in regular touch with the tourist or traveler. A tour guide's job is physically and virtually demanding. Phases. Now let us talk about phases in tour guiding. There are different phases in tour guiding. First phase, 3000 BC to 500 AD. Second phase, we discussed, that is from 500 to 1500 AD. Third phase, 1500 AD to around 1700 AD. And fourth phase is after post or 1700 AD. Tour guiding. A tour guide is a person employed to show the tourist around places of interest. The activity of guiding tourist during a tour is known as tour guiding. Tour guiding is ancient activity. Keywords in this lecture are Greek tourism, Cicerone, Grand Tours, LCC, Adventure Tour, WTO, IATO, TAAI, GOI, MOT. Now let me summarize my today's lecture. A tour guide is a person employed to show the tourist around places of interest. His or her job is to explain the place, people, culture, heritage, ethos, stories, geography, languages, traditions, festivals to the tourist. He makes them aware about their objectives behind traveling. Mostly that is happiness experience. We used to call it psychic gratification. The guiding history was classified by Pond in 1993 into four periods. It can be divided into four phases. These are first phase, as I told you, 300 BC to 500 AD. Second phase, 500 to 1500 AD. Third phase, 1500 to 1700 AD. Fourth phase, post or after 1700 AD. The activity of guiding tourist during tour is tour guiding. A tourist requires the attention of a guide to ensure meeting the expectations of clients. Tour guiding is an ancient activity. Thank you.